हेलो, माय सेल्फ राकेश अमृतकर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, नासिक। टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बाय क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस, हाउ टू इन्वेस्टिगेट, हाउ टू परफॉर्म द क्वालिटेटिव टेस्ट टू चेक टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड। दिस इज इंक्लूडेड इन द ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री नंबर 1 इन फर्स्ट ईयर बी फार्म। अपॉन कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन और दिस प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट, स्टूडेंट्स आर एबल टू नो द डेफिनेशन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सम ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसीजर एंड रिएक्शन इन्वॉल्व इन द आइडेंटिफिकेशन टेस्ट, एंड हाउ टू इन्वेस्टिगेट, आइडेंटिफाई एंड कन्फर्म द गिवन अननोन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड बाई सिस्टमिक क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस। फर्स्टली, दिस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स आर एनी ऑफ द लार्ज क्लास ऑफ केमिकल कंपाउंड्स इन विच वन और मोर atoms of carbon are covalently linked to atoms of the other elements. Mostly the atoms are hydrogen, oxygen or nitrogen. Basically, these organic compounds are classified into twos. This first one is acyclic or open chain. It is also called as aliphatic compounds and cyclic compounds. The cyclics are again divided into two parts, two classes, homocyclic compounds and heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic means the cyclic ring system is inserted with the heteroatom called as oxygen, sulfur or nitrogen. In that also, these are the two types. Alicyclic compounds means it is fully saturated and aromatic compounds are unsaturated. Example is pyridine and tetrahydrofuran is example of alicyclic compound. This homocyclics are aromatic compounds and alicyclic compounds are carboxylic. Example is cyclopropane. These aromatic compounds are again divided into two, that is benzonoid compound or aromatic homocyclic, that is phenols, and if this is a non-benzonoid compound, also it is aromatic homocyclic, means the two rings are fused with each other. This is the basic classification of organic compounds. Once again I repeat, these organic compounds are any of the large class of chemical compounds in which one or more atoms of the carbon are covalently linked to the atoms of other elements. Mostly commonly atoms are hydrogen, oxygen or nitrogen, etc. While considering this practical part, some points to be considered before outlining this general scheme, one or two points of the practical importance should be noted. The first one is quantities of the substance for test. For most tests, about 0.1 gram solid or 2 to 3 drops of liquid material should be used for this practical for qualitative analysis. Students are advised to develop a general knowledge of physical characteristic of common organic compounds. If in the doubt about this expected result of the test between certain compounds, and the reagents carry out a trial test with a known compound and compare with the unknown. Third point is quantitatives of substance derivatives. Students have wasted much time and material in the past by taking too large quantities of the substances for preparation of this derivative. Generally, 0.5 to 1 gram or 0.5 to 1 ml of the substance gives the most satisfactory result. So you must take only a 0.5 to up to 1 gram for this preparation of derivative. If the practical book instructs one or use larger quantities, so you should be minimize this up to 3 to 4 gram or more. Quantity should be scaled down up to the 1 gram or 1 ml of the unknown substance, and corresponding quantities of the reagent should be used. So the major part, that is identification or investigation of this unknown substance, is an important part of this organic chemistry. A systematic scheme for identification of organic compound is outlined below. There are 6 to 7 steps to confirm this organic compound. The first one is preliminary test, which include state, color, order, aliphatic or aromatic compounds to identify this whether the compound is aliphatic or aromatic, or to check whether it is saturated or unsaturated, etc. The second one is solubility test. Third one is the detection of extra elements like nitrogen, sulfur and halogen by sodium fusion test, or it is also called as Lassigny's test. The fourth one is detection of this functional group test like phenols, amides, urea, carbohydrates, etc., alcohols, then aromatic or halogenated hydrocarbons are also there. nitro compounds, annelids, etc. And the last one, fifth one, is identification of this unknown compound from the literature using melting point and boiling point. And the next one is confirmatory test. We should perform the confirmatory test for this functional groups and preparation of the derivatives and confirmation of unknown compound by taking its melting point and boiling point. These are the seven tests should be performed for identification of the organic compound. So the first tests are preliminary test, which includes state, color, odor, and aromaticity, and saturation and unsaturation. Note that the physical characteristics are state, color, and odor. So first one is, if the state is solid in nature, the inference is it may be a carbohydrate, some acids are there, for example, benzoic acid, phthalic acid. Some phenols are there in solid in state, for example, alpha naphthol, beta naphthol, some amines are there, and higher hydrocarbons may be present. And some liquids, if the compound is liquid in nature, it may be alcohol, ketone, aldehyde, ester, phenol, and amines are there. In case of this color, if the solid is yellowish in color, it may be a metadienitrobenzene or paranitrotoluene, etc. If yellowish liquid is there, so it is nitrogen containing benzene, it is nitrobenzene. Then brown color, that is paratolidine or resorcinol. It is blackish color is alpha naphthol, pink color is beta naphthol, buff or reddish color is aniline, phenol, or aromatic amines. Or some compounds are colorless. The examples are some simple acids, alcohols, esters, ketone, aromatic hydrocarbons, etc. Then orders, if carbolic order is there, so it may be a phenol or cresol. Then fishy order indicates it should be it may be amine. If the order is sweet and pleasant, so it may be a ester, alcohol, and halogen derivatives. Like if the order is bitter almond type of order, it is nitrobenzene or benzaldehyde. Then mothballs, it inference is naphthalene. Or if the compound does not show any type of smell, so it may be aromatic acids or carbohydrates or some amides does not show the smell to this. The another test is Pelstein test, which is it is used for the detection of whether the compound is aromatic or aliphatic. If the compound is aromatic in nature, it shows a sooty flame, and some aliphatic compounds containing small proportion of hydrogen. The examples are carbon tetrachloride, and the compound is aliphatic compounds. It does not show a sooty flame, means a non-sooty flame, and if substance jars out, it confirms the carbohydrate or sulfonic acid is there. This Pelstein test is a simple qualitative test used for the organic halides. It is developed by the Friedrich Konrad Pelstein. It's a scientist. The procedure for this, a copper wire is cleaned and heated in the Bunsen burner flame to form this coating of copper oxide. It is then dipped into the sample to be tested and once again heated in the flame. So this copper foil is heat in the Bunsen burner up till this green color in the flame is disappears. There are different flames of the Bunsen burners depending on the air flow through the valves. The air valve close, for example, this is the first one. If air valve close, so it shows this type of flame. If the air valve nearly fully close, the second observation is this type of flame is observed. If third air valve is semi open, the third picture is given in this, it observes this type of flame. And if air valve maximally open, so this clear, it indicates it clear flame is observed. So these are the some diagrammatic pictures of sooty flame and non sooty flame. So observation is this, these are the sooty flame, means the compound is aromatic compound. These compound aromatic compound shows this type of flame, that is sooty flame, and aliphatic compound shows this type of flame, that is non-sooty flame. So next test is test for unsaturation. That is, it is also called as Bayer's test. This test is used for the identification whether the compound is unsaturation, saturated organic compound. Means the presence of carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon single bond in the organic compound. So the procedure for this, take out this substance and add 2 ml of water, shake well. Then 2 drops of dilute potassium permanganate, or sometimes it requires 2 to 4 drops of dilute 1% KMnO4 solution with stirring. If the pink color of KMnO4 solution disappears, it may changes to reddish brown color. So these compounds are unsaturated, or these compounds easily oxidizable compounds. For examples, most of the phenols and the simple ketones are there, then lactic acid, citric acid, etc. Some amines are also shows a decolorization of this KMnO4. Then no decolorization means it does not change the color of KMnO4, means the compound is saturated. And means there is a presence of or absence of carbon-carbon double bond. In this case, this decolorization of KMnO4 solution is due to the unsaturation or oxidation of easily oxidizable groups. This compound containing a carbon-carbon double bond shows a decolorization of this KMnO4. These compounds are ethylenic and acetylenic linkages decolorizes the purple color of aqueous potassium permanganate, which may changes to reddish brown precipitate. It indicates the presence of unsaturation. Means, in short, olefins are oxidized to glycols. So this is the comparative color comparison of this. This is the pink color of KMnO4, and well, when this compound is it shows unsaturation, means the pink color of KMnO4 solution disappears, or it may change to reddish to brown color. The solution discharge color and a brown flux is formed. This is alkene and alkynes are present. If it does not changes the color, so it is what same color, means no decolorization of this KMnO4. This alkenes, it's been reacted with, here is the reaction when alkenes are reacted with this potassium permanganate, pinkish purple color. It forms 1,2-glycol by byproducts are manganese oxide and the potassium manganate. Shows a brown color. Manganese oxide shows a brownish color. So the next test after upon completion of this preliminary evaluation of the organic compound, the second step for the identification of these organic compounds are to check the solubility. There are two possibilities: whether the compound is soluble in water, or if it is liquid, if it is miscible in water, and if this compound is insoluble in water. There are two possibilities are there. So the first test to perform this solubility in water. So first one is take a 0.1 gram of substance plus 3 ml of water to gives if the substance dissolve, so it shows a lower members of alcohol, esters, ketones and carbohydrates. And if it is soluble, so taste the solution with the litmus paper. If it changes, blue litmus changes to turns red, if water soluble acid or phenol may be present, it confirms, or if the red litmus paper turns blue, water soluble base present. And if no action on the litmus paper, it inferences water soluble neutral compound is present in this test. So another test is if the compound is dissolves in saturated sodium bicarbonate solution. And to this, if the strong effervescences are there, so if it confirms that water soluble acid is present. And in this water soluble compound or saturated substance is soluble in saturated sodium bicarbonate. To this clear solution, you must add this concentrated HCl. If the no solid appears, it confirms the water soluble acid is present. And if it gives a precipitate of this, so water insoluble acid is present. Another solubility test is substance plus water, shake well, and the substance is dissolved to this clear solution and alcoholic ferric chloride solution. If it shows a blue to violet color, it confirms that the compound is water soluble, phenol is present. So another possibility is if the substance is insoluble in water or the substance is immiscible in water. So the tests are substance plus sodium bicarbonate. If strong effervescence are there, then carboxylic acid may be present. After filtration, you must add a concentrated HCl into this by drop by drop, and if it solid is appears, it confirms the carboxylic acid. Another one is if a substance is dissolved in dilute sodium hydroxide solution and it dissolves, observation if solid or emulsion is appears, this phenol may be present. And after filtration, you can add this concentrated HCl to this, so phenol is confirmed. Another test for this immiscible or insoluble in water compounds. Take this sample and add 3 ml of this 1:1 HCl solution and shake well. If it shows a clear solution, then add 20% of sodium hydroxide drop by drop. It solid is appears in the base, it's confirmed. If the substance is insoluble in all these three, sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide, and 1:1 HCl, so that compound is confirmed. It is a neutral in nature. That compound is neutral in nature. So these are the tests which is useful for the substances insoluble or immiscible in water. The next step for identification or investigation is detection of extramolecular elements like nitrogen, sulfur, and halogen by sodium fusion extract preparation or Lassigny's test. The sodium fusion extract test or Lassigny's test is the procedure for this. Or before this procedure, why we perform this Lassigny's test? Because these organic compounds consist of two or more elements in this. Apart from the carbon and hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens can also be present. So in order to detect this organic compound or this element, these organic compounds are non-ionic in nature. Therefore, it is in order to detect these elements in organic compound, it is necessary to convert them into water soluble ionizable inorganic substances so that the ionic test of inorganic qualitative analysis may be applied. So this conversion is accomplished by this method when our organic compound is treated with sodium metal. So the procedure for this, take a small piece of dry sodium metal in the fusion tube and heat it gently till this it melts or fuses. Add equal quantity of compound to this fused metal. If the compound is liquid, then add 2 drops of it with the capillary. Heat it gently, then strongly till it becomes red hot. Plug this red hot tube in 10 ml or 3 by 4 of the test tube of distilled water taken in the porcelain dish, covering it with immediately with asbestos sheet. Crush the fusion tube completely. Carry out more fusion in similar way 2 to 3 times and boil the extract for few minutes. Reduce the volume up to 5 ml and filter it. And perform this following test by using this filtrate. Means that test for nitrogen, sulfur, and halogens are to be performed by using this filtrate, that is sodium fusion extract. When the sodium metal is react with this carbon and nitrogen, it gives you sodium cyanide. It is sodium sulfate and sodium halide in this sodium fusion extract. So the first test is test for nitrogen. Take 1 ml of extract. Which extract? It is a sodium fusion extract, and add 2 to 3 drops of sodium hydroxide solution to make it alkaline, and add a few drops of freshly prepared ferrous sulfate. Or sometimes crystals may be used, and boil for a few minutes. Cool and acidify it with by adding dilute HCl or sulfuric acid. So in this case, it forms a Persian blue color, and the Persian blue color is of sodium ferrocyanide. Sodium ferrocyanide is generated once NaOH and ferrous sulfate is react with each other with sodium cyanide to give a ferric ferrocyanide, which having a Persian blue color. So the another test for element detection is detection of sulfur present in the organic compound. The procedure for this: when 1 ml of sodium fusion extract, and add 1 ml of 2 normal acetic acid plus 1 ml of lead acetate solution. It gives a black precipitate. It confirms the sulfur is present. When lead acetate is reacted with sodium sulfate to form this lead sulfate, which is having a black color. And another test is sodium fusion extract plus 1 drop of sodium nitroprusside, which is freshly prepared. It gives you violet or sometimes purple or deep red color. It also confirms the sulfur element is present in the unknown organic compound. The another test for halogen. The test for halogen is sodium fusion extract plus 1 ml of dilute nitric acid. Boil well. If the nitrogen and sulfur is present, then add 1 ml of 5% silver nitrate solution. A thick white precipitate is present. It confirms the halogen is present. But after completion of this test, only halogen is confirmed. But which type of halogen is present in the organic compound, which is tested by another test? For example, by taking the sodium fusion extract and add dilute sulfuric acid, by adding this 0.5 ml of chloroform and 0.5 ml of chlorine water. Shake well and observe the color of chloroform layer. If the chloroform layer shows a yellow violet color, iodine is confirmed. If it shows yellow to brown color, the bromine is confirmed. And if colorless layer of or white color of this chloroform, it shows chlorine halogen is present in the organic compound. Upon completion of this preliminary solubility and the elements present in the organic compound, so you must categorize our compound in the four groups. Means if your compound is not having nitrogen, sulfur and halogen, and if on the basis of solubility of organic compound, so that compound is in the group number one. Means some carboxylic acid, phenols and neutrals does not contain nitrogen and sulfur. It is under the heading of group number 1. If group 2s are only carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, if nitrogen is present in the organic compound by as per the element detection test, it may be a base also, acid, phenol, base and neutral. Means the nitrogen is present in acids, phenols as well as in the neutral compounds. Then if the group number 3, that is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur, it may be acids and neutrals. And group number 4 is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and halogen. That compound is neutral in nature. Means group number 4 compounds contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen along with the halogen, means the neutral compounds. and group number 3 contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur. Elements are present in the unknown organic compound. This is very important for selection of the group. According to this group, you can carry out the functional group test or confirmatory test.
Of solid organic compound belonging to the class of carboxylic acid. The first one is benzoic acid, then salicylic acid, and this is para amino benzoic acid, which is also called as the anthranilic acid. Further, from the phenolic compounds, examples are beta naphthol and alpha naphthol, having the color pinkish to brownish color. One is these compounds are basic in nature. Example is para nitroaniline and meta nitroaniline. These compounds are under the heading of basic organic compounds, and these are the some neutral organic compounds. Examples: urea, thiourea, then dextrose from carbohydrate category, then acetamide, benzamide from the amide, and acetanilide. These are the some examples of solid organic compound. Class examples are phenol, then aniline, then benzaldehyde, etc.
Now here is the Bellsten test, which is also called as heating of the compound on the copper foil. So first take this copper foil and heat it in the flame until this green color of flame is disappears. This test is useful for the identification of whether the compound is aliphatic or aromatic in nature. So first heat this copper foil and take a small amount of compound on this copper foil, and then heat gently and observe the flame. If the flame is sooty flame, the compound is aromatic in nature. Again, I am repeating this. Yes, it's a sooty flame, means the compound is aromatic. Yes, it's aromatic compound. This is the Bayer's test for unknown organic compound, which is useful for the detection of whether this compound is saturated or unsaturated. So the procedure is take a 0.1 to 0.2 gram of this organic compound into the test tube. Then add 2 ml of water. Dissolve it properly. If it does not dissolve, add 1 to 2 ml of alcohol. After this, add 2 ml of 10% sodium carbonate. Then add drops of potassium permanganate. While observing the color, it changes, pink color changes to reddish to brown color, means the pink color of this KMnO4 disappears, means the compound is unsaturated compound. I am repeating again this test. The test is called as Bayer's test. So for this Bayer's test, take a 0.1 to 0.2 gram of unknown organic compound into your test tube. Add 2 ml of water. If the sample is not dissolved, add sufficient amount of alcohol to solubilize it. Then add 2 ml of sodium carbonate. 10% sodium carbonate is used for this particular reaction. And add 3 to 4 drops of potassium permanganate. If this color of KMnO4 disappears, the inference is this compound is unsaturated in nature. If there is no decolorization, so compound is saturated compound. This is very important test for the identification of unknown organic compound, whether this compound is saturated or unsaturated in nature.
This decolorization of KMnO4 solution is due to this unsaturation or oxidation of easily oxidizable groups are present. Solubility in 10% sodium hydroxide. Add this 0.2 gram of organic compound and add 1 to 2 ml of this sodium hydroxide solution. If it is soluble at room temperature, maybe acid or phenol. Here is insoluble, so it may be a because first this organic compound is clearly shows effervescence in sodium bicarbonate. So this compound is maybe a carboxylic acid. As per this observation, while adding this sodium hydroxide in the same compound, it does not solubilize. It gets precipitate. So phenols is absent. So it may be a carboxylic acid. So the solubility in 50% hydrochloric acid. Take this 0.2 gram of compound and add 1 to 2 ml of this 50% hydrochloric acid. If it is soluble at room temperature, so this compound may be amines or nitroanilines, but it is insoluble, so write it down in inference. It is observation is insoluble, organic compound is insoluble in 50% hydrochloric acid, means the absence of amines and nitroanilines, etc. So the treatment of this organic compound with the concentrated sulfuric acid for the solubility purpose, take this 0.2 gram of organic compound and add 1 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. If it is soluble so it may be some aromatic hydrocarbons or phenols with the violet action, but here is insoluble, means the absence of some aromatic hydrocarbons or phenol. This compound is insoluble in concentrated H2SO4. While this compound is soluble in this concentrated H2SO4, so it may be a aromatic hydrocarbon or phenol. Procedure for preparation of sodium fusion extract, and this test is also known as Lassigny's test. Firstly, collect the fresh piece of sodium metal into the sodium fusion tube. Dip into the sodium fusion tube by using capillaries. Then heat until it melts. Then add a small amount of organic compound into the sodium fusion tube containing sodium metal. Heat again until it sodium fusion tube is red hot in nature. Yes, it is a red hot while observing, and put this sodium fusion tube into the distilled water. Sodium fusion extract will be prepared by taking this sodium metal, repeating the procedure 2 to 3 times. Again, I am taking to get the concentrate of the sodium fusion extract. Again, I am taking the sodium metal into the sodium fusion tube and insert by using this capillary. Heat until it melts. Then take a small amount of organic compound . Heat this, and the lower end of fusion tube will be red hot. Put this fusion tube into the distilled water collected into the porcelain dish and repeat this procedure for 2 to 3 times. Crush this sodium fusion tubes and heat for 10 to 15 minutes to get the fusion extract. Now the test for element detection. The first one is nitrogen test. Test for nitrogen. Take 2 ml of sodium fusion extract which is already prepared. Add 0.1 gram of ferrous sulfate. And 1 ml of sodium hydroxide solution. Boil the solution gently. Boil this solution and add a dilute sulfuric acid. So there is no formation of Persian blue color, means here is the nitrogen is absent in this organic compound. Nitrogen is absent. I am repeating again this test. Test for nitrogen. Take a 2 ml of sodium fusion extract. Add 0.1 to 0.2 gram of this ferrous sulfate and 1 ml of sodium hydroxide solution. Boil this solution gently and then add just sufficient dilute sulfuric acid. If the solution is Persian blue color, means the nitrogen is present, but in this case there is no formation of Persian blue color, so nitrogen element is absent in the given unknown organic compound. This is the test for sulfur detection. Take a 2 ml of sodium fusion extract. Then add 2 ml of glycyl acetic acid. Then add 4 to 5 drops of lead acetate. If there is appearance of black or brown precipitate, there is a presence of sulfur, but here in this case the sulfur element is absent because it does not form the black or brown precipitate. While this lead acetate and glycyl acetic acid reacted with this sodium fusion extract. Test for halogen detection. Take 2 ml of sodium fusion extract which is already prepared. Then add dilute nitric acid. Then add silver nitrate around 1 ml. If
the yellowish color is yellowish or white color is appears, there is a presence of halogen, but in this case there is no white or yellow precipitate, so halogen is absent for this particular given unknown organic compound. Here is the confirmatory test for carboxylic acid, which contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen only, means group number 1. This compound does not contain elements like nitrogen, sulfur and halogen. So we have to perform the test for carboxylic acid, type carboxylic acid and the group number 1, which contains only carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So the first test is sodium bicarbonate test. Add this 0.2 gram of substance and add 2 ml of this sodium bicarbonate. There is a effervescence of carbon dioxide, means it confirms that this given unknown organic compound is carboxylic acid. So this is the effervescence while adding this bicarbonate into this. So this is the confirmatory test for presence of this carboxylic acid. And while adding this dilute hydrochloric acid into this, there is a reappearance of the substance, means it confirms this carboxylic acid is present. Here we are adding this hydrochloric acid. There is a reappearance of this carboxylic acid. It confirms the given compound is carboxylic acid. Here is the appearance of or reappearance of the given unknown organic compound. So this is the confirmatory test for carboxylic acid, which contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen only, means the absence of all types of remaining elements like nitrogen, sulfur and halogens. So this is the confirmatory test called as sodium bicarbonate. So here is the reappearance of this organic compound in sodium bicarbonate test. So this is the another confirmatory test for carboxylic acid containing carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, called as neutral test. So take 0.2 to 0.3 gram of this unknown organic compound, then add 1 drop of phenolphthalein. Add 1 ml of water. And 0.2 ml of ammonia solution. Boil until this excess of ammonia removes. After cooling, add dilute ferric chloride solution and observe the color. It shows a buff color precipitate, means it confirms that this given unknown organic compound contains carboxylic acid functional group, and it confirms it is benzoic or phthalic acid. It shows a buff color precipitate while adding this ferric chloride into the solution. This test is called as neutral test. In this test, I am repeating again, take a 0.2 to 3.3 gram of this organic compound, add phenolphthalein, then add water into this. After adding this water, add 0.2 ml of ammonia and boil. If the excess of ammonia is removed out, and cool again and add few drops of ferric chloride, it observe that buff color precipitate is obtained. There is a presence of benzoic or phthalic acid. So this given unknown organic compound is benzoic acid or phthalic acid, which is also confirmed by taking this physical constant equation. Now we will see the actual part, practical part of preparation of amide derivative from the carboxylic acid. Here, take this carboxylic acid in test tube. Add thiamine chloride or phosphorus pentachloride. Here we are taking this thiamine chloride. Take a precautions while adding this thiamine chloride. Use of fume cupboard is necessary. Till the vigorous reaction occurs. After addition of thionyl chloride or phosphorus pentachloride, this solution will be warmed gently and then cooled. After cooling, add concentrated ammonia solution. Here is the precipitate of amide derivative of carboxylic acid. I am repeating the procedure. First take the carboxylic acid in the test tube and add thionyl chloride or phosphorus pentachloride to generate this acid chloride. After adding this, warm the solution gently and then cool it. And after cooling, add sufficient amount of concentrated ammonia to get the precipitate of amide derivative of carboxylic acid. Filter of the amide derivative of carboxylic acid. After drying of this compound, you get this amide derivative of carboxylic acid. Take the physical constant of the same.
Now the questions for synopsis. First question, classify the given compound on the basis of element present. There are four types of groups. Group number 1, which contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. It includes carboxylic acid, phenols and neutral type of compounds. Group number 2 group number 2 contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Carboxylic acids, phenols and bases, base and neutral, these type of compounds are included in the group number 2. Group number 3 contains, along with carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur is present in these type of organic compounds. That compounds may be acids or neutrals. Group number 4 contains halogens as an extra element, which is present in the neutral. Sometimes this acids also or phenols also substituted with the halogens. Second question, give the confirmatory test for phthalic acid. Test is, take a compound and add 1 ml of water, shake well, dissolve it properly and add 1 to 2 drops of alcoholic ferric chloride solution. The observation is buff color precipitate is obtained. It confirms that its organic compound is phthalic acid. Question number 3, give the procedure and reaction for detection of extra elements like nitrogen, sulfur and halogen by Lassigny's test. The procedure is, take a small piece of dry sodium metal in Friedland tube and heat it gently till the metal melts or fuses. Add equal quantity of compounds to this fused metal. If the compound is liquid, then add 2 drops of compound with by using this capillary. Heat it gently, then strongly till it becomes red hot. Plug this red hot tube in 10 ml of distilled water, which is taken in the porcelain dish, covering it with immediately with the asbestos sheet. Crush the fusion tube completely and carry out the more fusion in similar way 2 to 3 times. Boil the extract for a few minutes and reduce the volume up to 5 ml and filter. Here the reaction: when sodium is react with this carbon and nitrogen, it gives sodium cyanide. Then sodium is react with the sulfur, sodium sulfate is generated. If sodium is react with the halogen, sodium halide, that is it, X may be chlorine, bromine or iodine. This is the procedure and reaction for detection of extra elements present in the organic compound. Give the qualitative test for detection of halogen. Test is: take 1 ml of sodium fusion extract and add dilute nitric acid. Boil well if nitrogen and sulfur is present, and add 1 ml of 5% silver nitrate solution. The observation is a thick white precipitate is obtained, confirms that halogen is present. But which type of halogen? For this, if the halogen is present, carry out the following test: 1 ml of extract plus 1 ml of dilute sulfuric acid and 0.5 ml of chloroform, and add 0.5 ml of chlorine water. Shake well and observe the color of chloroform layer. If the chloroform layer observed with the violet or yellow color, it confirms the iodine is present. If it changes to brown color, then bromine is present. If that chloroform layer is whitish or colorless, confirms the chlorine is present. So here is the reaction: when sodium chloride, sodium bromide and sodium iodide is react with the silver nitrate, it forms the white precipitate in first, silver chloride, then yellow precipitate in bromide, then iodide shows a yellow precipitate when it react with the silver nitrate. Last question: why it is necessary to prepare sodium fusion extract? The halogens, nitrogen and sulfur are covalently bonded to these organic compounds. In order to detect them, the elements need to be converted into their ionic forms. This is done by fusing the compound with sodium metal. The ionic compounds formed during this fusion are extracted in aqueous solution and then detected by simple chemical test. This extract is called as sodium fusion extract or lacemic extract. These are some questions on synopsis. Upon completion of all the test step by step analysis of this organic compound, so this is the format for result. You have to report state, color, order, aromaticity, aliphaticity, then whether this unknown organic compound is saturated or unsaturated, then solubility in different organic solvents, then which type of extra elements are present in the organic compound, which is performed by sodium fusion extract, then functional group is present, which functional group is present, and which test you have to use for confirmation of this functional group, and last one is physical constant or melting point or boiling point. This is the format for result of investigation of given unknown organic compound